Welcome to the Configure Validation Table tutorial. This tutorial will focus on the setup of MapInfo Pro tables for valid data entry utilizing the pick lists. MapInfo Pro tables can have the following validation rules applied. Okay, let's get started. Navigate to the Discover tab. On the Discover tab, go to the Data Entry group and the Setup drop-down. In previous tutorials, we investigated the Pick List Manager. In this tutorial, we will concentrate on the Setup table. Okay, under the Select Tables dialog, select the table you wish to perform valid data entry on. In this case, ISA Geology. If you need to open another table, click the Open button. You will be presented with the Setup Digitizing Table dialog. At the top of the dialog, we have Table Options. Under that, we have the table name, the projection used for the table, and the location of the table. Once again, if you wish to open up another table, click on the Folder button here. Under the Table Options are the various table fields and options for those fields. The Name column, they're the names of all the fields which are presented within that ISA Geology table. Next to that we have Type. These are the types of field. In this case we have Character and we have the Date. You can also see the length of the Character field presented. The next column along is Parameter. This is where we can put various parameters on the particular column. In this case, you may want to repeat a value. And for the date field, you may want to present the current date, so the date which is now, or repeat a value. The visible column, this gives you the option of presenting the field or hiding the field. So if you uncheck that, when you open up the table next time in the browser, it will be hidden. The lookup table, this is where we present our pick lists. If we check there, we can see all the pick lists which are contained from our pick list manager. The pick lists are broken up into various object types. We have points, which are structural, lines, polylines, region objects, and not displayed here, you can also have just simple text. What the exclusive column allows you to do, if you check the option here, all values within the pick list will be exclusively used. So you have no option for freehand text. If you uncheck the exclusive column, this means that all values from the pick list will be presented, and also you can freehand type in other values. Optional. When we have a pick list selected, you can uncheck this, and that will make sure that that pick list is mandatory, so you must enter a value. If you have optional selected, that will mean that you can select a value from the pick list, or you can leave the field blank. Alternatively, for values and fields without a pick list, you can set the same as well for optional and not optional. Moving along, we have default values. If you wish to have a default value presented to you in a column or a field, this is where you set it. It can either be a value of time, date, character, or numerical. The Map Style column. This is quite an important column and is used when you have a pick list with an object style. For instance, in the example we will set later on, we've got the ISA Geology. We have the patterns and the color fills. When we select a particular pick list entry, you may want the color values and patterns to be displayed as well when you digitize. You can only have one object map style for each table. The increment column. That can be used either on a character or a numeric field. What this allows is you may want to increment a value by 1, 2, 10, 100, etc. This can also work in character fields where you have an alphanumeric string. For example, whole IDs. You may have HID 001 and you want to increment by 1, it will perform the increment on this field. Moving further along, this is where we can cap values. You can have minimum values, maximum numeric values, minimum date, maximum date, min date time, max date time, and also time. As this tutorial is focusing on the use of pick lists, I will demonstrate how to associate a pick list with the table column and demonstrate how the object style of the pick list can automatically update selected map objects. Okay, so I'm navigating to the unit name column, which is this one here. I go to the table lookup and I select isogeology. You'll notice next to each pick list are the symbols. So this is either region or polygon, because we're going to be performing this on a region or polygon data set. The unit name field is the basis for the geological polygon pattern fills. With this in mind, the pick list can be used as both a drop-down list and to modify the pattern fill for new or existing map objects. So under the field name unit name, we're going to navigate to the map style column and we check that. So with this table set up in mind, what will happen is whenever we perform any new digitizing on an object or we modify an object, the respective map style will be updated relative to the unit name attribute selected. The map style option enables the pattern fills of the pick list to be used when selecting a pick list entry. This will change the map object pattern fill. The same pick list can be used multiple times. It doesn't just have to be on the one column. For the next update, we're going to go to the age column here and go to lookup table. In this instance, we're going to go to isogeology age. If we go over to default value and click on there, you can see all the entries which exist within that isogeology age pick list. If we leave that blank, when we enter a new object type, you'll be presented with this list rather than a default value. However, we may want to have the Cambrian as the default. So it's entirely up to you how you set these things up. And finally, we're going to go to date entered. Under the parameter dropdown, I want to do current date. So when I create a new polygon or update another polygon, it will place in the current or the now date. So you can see when this data has been updated, which is quite handy. So all we need to do now is save the table. Just click save and we can close the dialog. The table is now ready for data entry. You may ask, where are all these configurations, pick lists, and drop downs and parameters stored? A quick way to reveal where this information is we go to the projection info button. Down the bottom right is an edit in notepad button. Click on that. And what that reveals is the mapinfo.tab file. So we can see here we've got some discover metadata in there and table validation. So all those parameters that we inserted, things like the map style, the lookup tables, and the date entered, is all contained within the tab file. So where this is handy is the actual data and the configurations move around with the table. There's no extra configuration files or tables you need to copy for all this information to travel with the table. This concludes the tutorial, which demonstrates how to set up a MapInfoPro table for valid data entry. The next tutorial will concentrate on how to actually use this table setup and start entering data in a valid format. Thank you.